scum of the earth, drunken, un-Australian morons. Those are the harsh words from union boss John Sector, describing yesterday's violent protests in Melbourne, blaming demonstrators as the reason construction workers will be out of work for at least the next fortnight. And this morning, the city is again on edge with more rallies planned in the next couple of hours. We're joined now by John Sector from the CFMEU. John, good morning to you. Thanks for your time. Look, Bill Shorten said you were taken over by man-baby Nazis yesterday. Is that about right?
That's about right. It's a pretty fair assessment, Carl.
Tell me what happened.
Well, I mean, a few construction workers came to the office. It just grew and grew. We got to a couple of hundred. I went out there with a couple of my executive officers to just address them. So we got nothing to be scared of. We've done nothing wrong. Want to see what it's all about. Went out there and I seen there was a sprinkling of construction workers there, of our members, and the rest were just people. I wouldn't even know who they are. You couldn't even talk. We tried to keep it all calm and it just got out of control. You know, people started throwing bottles. Some of them were fighting amongst themselves. You know, once I started throwing the bottles away, that was it. We just said, look, this is too dangerous. Let's move back in. And it's just got out of control from there on. And the crowd grew bigger. All these renter crowds that you've seen on the Saturday's protests were all there. Professional protesters. And it just got out of control.
Look, I've had pretty decent dealings with the CFMEU over the years. I reckon you'd have a pretty good idea on the division there between who was a renter crowd and who wasn't. Have you been able to tell the police what the division was? And were there actual neo-Nazis in the crowd?
I believe there was. I wouldn't know one if I fell over one, to be quite honest, Carl. But, I mean, my understanding is, yes, there's a few of them anti-vaxxer activists were there who are not union members. They're not from our industry. And they're the ones you see at all the protests. So, like I said, it just got out of control. And thanks to these... And then they were consuming a whole heap of alcohol. And thanks to these morons, 300,000 Victorians are sitting at home for at least the next couple of weeks. Could drag out even longer.
Wow.
And it's just tragic.
So on that part of it, because there are two different stories here. One was yesterday and the other is the ongoing battle with COVID inside the industry. But a two-week shutdown began at midnight for five local government areas. They include Ballarat, which is 150 k's away. Did you fight that?
Well, we didn't get much of a say in it, to be quite honest.
Yeah.
We were blindsided by some of it, to be quite honest. It's not like we sat in the room and there was all this full-on consultation going on with us.
So you had no conversation with Dan Andrews about the shutdown of the industry and outside of the Melbourne area?
I've never spoken to Daniel Andrews, to be quite honest. I've never met him and I've never spoken to him, so I've had no discussions with Daniel Andrews ever.
So is this a bit of payback then from the Andrews government? Because you were part of a number of unions who released a press release saying that the Dan Andrews government had been heavy-handed with health directions and that's led to more anti-vaxxers. Do you think this is payback for that?
I don't think it's payback for that, Carl. I just think people seen what was going on yesterday. It got out of control. It got pretty violent. I don't think they had much of an alternative but to do what they've done. It's unfortunate because families rely on a pay packet every week. And the problem with it is I think it's going to go longer than 2 weeks. And they can thank all them drunken morons yesterday that this lays squarely on their shoulders.
Don't get me wrong. I mean, I think yesterday was deplorable. It was incredibly embarrassing and awful. But there are also 99.9% of the industry in Victoria, do the right thing. You still have this element, though, that you have a problem with COVID and the anti-vaxxers even inside your union. How are you going to address that moving forward?
Oh, look, we are going to address it, Carl, I can assure you of that. I mean, look, we've always said we, you know, you've got to respect people's individual rights too. I mean, there's some people that have got a legitimate concern about being vaccinated and you've got to respect that. You can't just dismiss it and call them idiots. And we've said that all along. It's unfortunate it's come to a situation where the government has mandated it. But as far as we're concerned as a union, our job is to keep our members safe, make them, you know, make sure they're working safely, keep their family safe, keep your community safe. And you know what? We want to get back to doing what we all love doing as soon as possible. Building. And that's what it's all about. And let's get back on track.
John,
that's what we're all about.
Good to talk to you. Honest. I know there's more protests planned in the next couple of hours. I hope that that doesn't eventuate. Thanks for your time today. Appreciate it.
Thanks for joining us this morning. More now on those violent protests on the streets of Melbourne. Demonstrators turning on their own union over vaccine mandates. And last night, an extraordinary response from Daniel Andrews, shutting down most of the state's $22 billion construction industry for 2 weeks. There is plenty to unpack. The Shadow Minister for Government Services, Bill Shorten, joins me now in Melbourne and in Brisbane, 4BC's Scott Emerson. Nice to see you both this morning. Bill, what did you make of that yesterday?
I was shocked. I reached out to a couple of people I know who work in the building unions to find out last night if they were safe and what happened. And I noticed in your introduction you said these were workers turning on their own union. There were some construction workers in the crowd, according to my sources, but there were a lot of other just professional troublemakers. I never thought I'd see a scene where you have people who call themselves Nazis using encrypted message systems to bring in a renter crowd. I mean, some of those people in the crowd were construction workers, but others I'm reliably informed were fake tradies. They'd been down to the reject shop and got themselves a $2 high-vis hoodie so they could pretend they were construction. This is all because the construction unions have been responsible, have been running radio ads, have been encouraging people to get vaccinated, and that doesn't suit the hard right or the extremist agenda of some troublemakers. It was shocking violence against people who've been showing leadership in the construction industry.
Look, I mean, you make a good point there, Bill. There were a lot of ring-ins in that crowd, but there were also a lot of legitimate union members who were part of that and part of what happened yesterday.
Well, I can only go off what people told me who were trapped in the building by this crowd. Yes, there were some who were construction workers, but I'm saying, and I think I'm sure the police are aware of this too, that there is a very small group of people, not just in Melbourne, but around the country, hard right extremists who are trying to weaponise the COVID lockdown. Now, I can understand that there are some genuine people who don't want vaccinations. I can understand that there are many people frustrated by lockdowns. But what I'm saying on your show is, according to my sources who I spoke to yesterday, who were imperiled by this mob, just like the police were the previous day, there is a network of hard-right man-baby Nazis, you know, just people who just want to cause trouble, these man-babies. They want to complain about the vaccination. And it's just, they deserve to get the full force of everything that's coming their way.
All right, so the actions of this group yesterday, and we're hearing again they're going to meet at 10 a.m. this morning. You're saying, you know, most of it was from those outside of the union. It is now shut down, the entire industry across the state, 300,000 workers. Do you support that decision by Daniel Andrews overnight, Bill?
No one wants to see the industry shut down at all. No one. I'm sure not the government, not the construction workers and businesses, and not the unions either. But we do have a small number of people within construction who are making it impossible and intolerable to function properly in the short term. I mean, there was that... It was sort of amusing at one level where you had some construction tradies and people saying they were tradies sitting out in the main street having their lunch because they couldn't meet in their tea room. Well, we haven't seen the nurses and the doctors and the vaccinators out there, you know, carrying on like this.
So did Dan make the right call last night, Bill?
I don't know what other choices he had. I mean, you've got organised... I mean, this is a serious issue. We now have, in Australia, some people seeking to impose extreme views and extreme tactics. I'm not talking about Liberal versus Labor or the Nationals. I'm talking about a small minority of highly organised troublemakers. And the fact that they were coming after the union, because the union's actually been showing leadership and saying we want to have a safe workforce and we want to have safe work sites and we want a safe population, the union was targeted because it wasn't following the extremist ideology of a few troublemakers.
Well, the result you've got, if you're a tradie now in Ballarat, you can't go to work for the next 2 weeks. That's the reality of it. And, Scott, I mean, if you worked in hospitality, retail, tourism or any of the industries that have been shut for months now, what would you be thinking seeing those scenes?
Oh, well, extraordinary scenes. Ali, I have to say, I don't think I'd ever say these words previously. I felt sorry for John Setka yesterday under that. Look, the union has been doing the right thing. Look, I think Bill is downplaying how many genuine tradies and unionists were involved in that march and protest yesterday. An extraordinary scenes. But if you're not in one of those industries, and you're into those hospitality industries that have been shut down, doing all the right things, you just think how selfish, how extreme, how out of control those people are, with no insight and understanding of the impact it's having across Victoria now. People want to get out of lockdown, they want to do the right thing. Look, there is an element there of people who are clearly radical, who want to disrupt, and they have infiltrated many organisations, and for sure, I have no doubt that some of them were in that protest yesterday. But they were horrible scenes out there.
Oh, look, it was horrible, and you just felt for all the staff who were inside that building and for the police who are having to deal with it. Well, more now on those violent protests in Melbourne. Construction workers against vaccine mandates. And last night, Daniel Andrews responding by shutting down the industry for 2 weeks.
The co-owner of Stroud Homes, Simon Walsh, joins us now from Ballarat. Yep, Ballarat's included in this. Simon, firstly, welcome to the program. Good to have your company this morning. What did you make of those ugly scenes, firstly, yesterday?
Pretty frustrating. Got a lot of friends and family in hospitality and the healthcare sector and, you know, what they've already dealt with, and to see that sort of stuff was, frustrating, definitely.
Well, the actions of a couple of hundred now means 300,000 construction workers have got to down tools for 2 weeks. What does this mean for you?
It means we're shut for 2 weeks, and the construction industry, I suppose, has fed the economy for the last 2 years through this pandemic, and it just seems like a really knee-jerk reaction.
Why is Ballarat part of it? I mean, have you had much COVID spreading through the construction industry?
In the construction industry, I think we had one case from someone who was working in Melbourne. They weren't actually working in Ballarat. They just lived in Ballarat. So that's been our only case in our industry here. So I'm a bit puzzled as to why we're included, to be honest.
Right. Mm.
And look, it's not just Ballarat, of course. It's Geelong, the Surf Coast and the Mitchell Shire as well. We know that there have been hundreds of COVID cases linked to the construction industry. That's mainly, of course, in Melbourne. What's your stance on mandatory vaccines for your industry?
Got lots of friends and family in hospitality and the health sector, and it just feels like whatever we can do to open up and get things moving, I'm more than willing to do that.
You know, in the last couple of days, the CFMEU, ETU, Plumbers Union, AMWU, they all said and came out with the press release saying that Dan Andrews was heavy-handed in terms of health directions, and that had led to this drive of people towards anti-vaccinators. There has to be a balance here, but you've been basically put off work because of the actions of a few. If that was me, I'd be absolutely filthy.
Yeah, well, pretty wild. You know, we've talked about it in amongst our group and trades, and you know, it's not just me as a builder. It's the trades that go with it. It's the carpet shops that put the carpet in, like. You know, it goes far and wide, and all those people, you know, sitting up here in regional Victoria to see those scenes on the TV was, really frustrating.
Are you going to get compensation?
No idea.
Okay.
So we got a press release, I think, at, 11 o'clock last night to say, yeah, we're definitely in 2 weeks lockdown, and no information apart from that. So I woke up for a sleep-in this morning and got woken up by you guys. Yeah. But nice to be asleep in, but here I am.
Well, today's show is gainfully employing. just send us an email and we'll employ you. Good on you, mate. Thank you so much. This is a tough blow yesterday and late last night. We appreciate everything that you guys are going through. It's tough. Good on you, mate.
No worries. Appreciate it.